Welcome to Food Network Challenge, Disney's Beauty and the Beast cakes.
Can I call you Mama Bear? I'm just going to change your name a little bit.
My assistant is Karen Portaleo, who is actually my boss slash teacher. She's a sculptor, she's a painter, and sort of fell into cake design. She's teaching me how to be more of an artist and less of a cake designer. We're a really good pair, so I'm excited.
There's so few lines in Chip, but it's so easy to get it wrong.
Yeah. In order to do the stained glass, Karen drew out what she was going to put on this book. She actually pipes the scene with black royal icing and then puts colored gel in between each little scene.
In kitchen one with Joshua and Karen, the assistant, she has done a fabulous job with the piping of the stained glass images in the book.
Well, Joshua, I think the book on your cake is just a stunning piece, but looking at Mrs. Potts, I think her spout is a little bit too big. And Chip, who is this wonderful 5-6-year-old kid in the movie, he looks almost like a teenage version of Chip.
I love the book, but it's obliterated by Mrs. Potts. You could have downsized Mrs. Potts quite a bit so that in relation to the book, it would have been better for viewing. But I think overall, kudos to you.
Thank you.
Simple stroke of genius on the integration of the twist today.
The winner of Food Network Challenge, Disney's Beauty and the Beast cakes, is Joshua John Russell.
No way!
Congratulations, first time to win!
It's so great to finally win.
Sort of validates the fact that I took, you know, a risk and it paid off.
Joshua won this because overall was able to tell the story of Beauty and the Beast in a single presentation of their cake. The-